Time for the next installment of Desert Stars. If you like what Mad Cow, my wife, and I are doing here, please let us know in the comments. Let us know with your words, let us know with your subscriptions, your likes, hitting that bell notification. And if you have the financial means, consider joining the channel or making a one-time or many-time donation through Buy Me a Coffee. Enjoy. This is an official recording of Desert Stars, an unofficial Warhammer 40K story, written and narrated by Delio Para. Music and other sounds by Mad Cow. Chapter 20. 3 weeks later, Achella used her feet for the first time since she'd climbed into Daggerfly after finding the two satchels worth of Shallan. Malakad was in the room with her, as were three other lighthouses, Sevalkan, Amonti, and Ralkan. Amonti had made a pair of leg braces and a staff of trifiber that was as long as she was tall.
"Lean your weight on that as you get used to using your legs again.
Your new skin is going to be what takes the longest to get used to. It's still integrating with your body, even now, and probably won't be fully yours for another few months."
Achella braced herself with the staff and pushed off the bed. It took her a moment to find her balance as the room spun around her. She went to take her first step and fell. Or would have if not for Sevalkan appearing at her side to catch her. He'd been at least 6 feet from her, then had his hands on her shoulders, helping her regain her balance.
"Take it slow."
Sevalkan knelt and handed the staff back to Achella. The ground beneath her feet rolled, and her legs kept trembling. Try as she might to still them, they refused to calm. Again she tried to take a step, and again her knees gave out. Once more, Sevalkan caught her under the arms.
"You said she was ready for this," the chapter master said to Sevalkan. "She is. Doesn't quite seem like it."
Achella knew she could walk. What was stopping her was a lack of practice, not a lack of strength. She knew if she just had a little assistance, she could do it, but was too stubborn to say anything.
"I can do this without their help," she thought.
Once more, she went to take a step and almost managed to slip from Sevalkan's hands and fall again. Yet once again, he was there to keep her from crashing to the floor.
"Well, I suppose she's not quite as ready as I thought."
Malakad shook his head and let his arms fall to his side. It seemed to the others in the room he was about to put the girl back into bed until Amonti spoke up.
"I'd hoped her body was ready for this, but in the case it wasn't, I made those legs to compensate."
He waved for Sevalkan to step aside.
"She'll be fine. The legs will catch her."
The lighthouse chapter master stepped back. Achella wobbled on unsteady legs for a moment and looked as though she would fall again until there was a soft whir and the brace's actuators kicked in. The small servos pulled on cabling that held the framework rigid and prevented Achella from falling.
"You could try and fall and they wouldn't let you," Amonti grinned. "Go on, try."
"You want me to try and fall?"
The lighthouse weaponsmith nodded.
"Please, see if you can."
Sevalkan motioned for her to do as she'd been told. "I'll catch you if his machine fails."
"It won't."
"We'll see." Malakad crossed his arms again.
Achella decided she could go on about this in one of two ways. Start leaning over until she fell, or throw herself to the floor. She opted for the latter. If she was going to do as told, there was no reason to be shy about it. She lurched to her left, and her caged legs moved of their own accord and caught her, the machinery whirring to adjust to the sudden shift in balance. All but Amonte chuckled.
By the throne, I wasn't expecting you to do that. I'd figure you'd just try and tip over.
Achella's face flushed.
I thought about that, but wanted to see how good they were.
Well done, Brother Armorer. Were they hard to make?
Ralkin took a step closer to better see the contraption his battle brother had made.
Not so much, no. The basic idea is similar to the skeleton of our armor. The hardest thing was how small they are. My hands were no good for the fine work. I had to make some special tools and further augment SN-54 and SB-81. They're fast becoming my best tools for anything related to our tiny charge.
Achella had gone from taking slow, tentative steps to fully walking around the Medi-Hall. After her second pass around her bed, she picked up her pace and jogged from one end of the room to the other.
Give her another few hours and I'll have her training on the mats, said Ralkin, grinning.
Not until she's fully healed. Savalkin watched the girl dash around the room with the three other Astartes. It was a little like seeing an aspirant fresh from the trials in the desert. Only those male youths were typically so worn down from their tests that the only time they smiled was when they were asleep. The chapter master turned his attention from Achella to Malakad.
You said it would be a few months before her new skin was truly hers. Is there anything we could do to speed that up?
Malakad shrugged. I honestly don't have a clue. Everything about her is so small and strange.
Strange how?
Well, for one, she's a she. We've never had someone like her around us before. Besides that time on Flunan's mining platform, I've never done any Medicaid work on a female.
It can't be that different, can it? Ralkin was watching Achella scamper about the room and only half-minding the apothecary.
It's different enough.
Savalkin drew a long breath.
There's nothing that would help her. Surely there's something.
There very well may be indeed. All I said was I don't know.
Amonte cleared his throat. A suggestion? What about giving her a bit of our blood? I'm happy to offer mine if we're a match.
Would that work? Savalkin asked.
The apothecary's eyes widened.
I had considered it, but didn't do any tests. I suppose, at the very least, it would be informative.
He went to a counter where vials spun in humming machines. Set amidst the various medical devices sat a microscope. Amonte had unlocked his gauntlet and moved to maglock it to his waist when Malakad said,
Keep your blood under your skin, brother. I have plenty of samples.
It took him a few moments to get things ready, but after a little work, he had two drops of blood on a glass tile. The drop of Achilla's blood sat on the left of the tile, and Ralkin's was on the right. Malakad placed the tile into a gap in the microscope's base, then moved his eye to the viewport. He turned a dial, then another, adjusted his stance, and continued to make minute tweaks of the knobs.
Whose blood is that? Ralkin asked.
The apothecary ignored the question at first, still trying to find the best setting for what he wanted to see, then said,
Yours.
You've been listening to an official recording of Desert Stars, an unofficial Warhammer 40K story, written and narrated by Delio Pera. Music and other sounds by Mad Cow.